What an entrance.
Welcome to episode 8.
8.
The Rainout Show.
Game day rainout. Ever wonder what happens?
So we went home opener, rainout. So doubleheader weekend, sort of.
1.5. Because we're still bringing you this. No game.
We're about content here.
That's right.
Content's king.
Can we talk about, I came dressed for a little bit of a game day, hoping dressed to impress, maybe get a win here, and you're in your rainout gear.
I was dressed.
I love that.
I was dressed for game day.
Yes.
But then it didn't stop raining, so I dressed for the elements.
You did.
Also, I'm just, I'm really encouraged by what I saw on Thursday night at the home opener of the Fisherman's Race. I really just want to do it, but I can't because I got to run it.
It was awesome. A lot of good promos. You had a lot of fun downstairs.
I did.
Biggest crowd?
Well, let's talk about the home opener, I guess, really.
Yeah,
do you want to start with that?
Absolutely.
Biggest crowd of home opener in team history, 1276.
Yep.
Good number. And thank you for coming in that cold. It was freezing.
How many, I'm sure, sweatshirts were bought? Any toques?
I assume so.
Mittens?
Yes, one toque got sold.
Yeah.
You don't sell
You're
mittens.
A smart individual, whoever bought that toque, because I almost went down.
Mid-inning
and bought two.
That was like Alec was asking for a hoodie the entire time and it was freezing. But I mean, I was wearing shorts and a t-shirt and I know I was cold.
Got a tough
Well, when I ran around like 100 times, you get warm up. But
it's true. And the breeze up here for some reason was just bone chilling.
Well, that's the problem with the press box is there's two temperatures, freezing cold or scorching hot.
Yeah, mid-June, we'll be dripping before the first pitch
is
thrown.
You won't complain about
the
cold. So
then I wonder what Alec's going to ask for then.
Oh, he'll ask
Jack
for
a Jackfish fan?
He'll ask for a Speedo.
Alec.
Which reminds me, the boys downstairs, they're thinking about switching the drag race, or the drag infield dragging, to swimmers. And one of our interns just happens to be a swimmer, and he wants to wear a Speedo while he does it.
I don't see anything wrong with that. He's not going to use his body, though, right? To drag the...
No.
Wow. Someone pull a body?
No.
Tie rope around him.
So speaking of promotions, like we had some new good ones.
We did.
The Fisherman's Race, the guy's like last minute win.
It was a come from behind win.
I know, it was awesome.
It was wild.
We love those.
That was
I think
win.
They broke the boat, to be honest with you.
No.
Well they weren't real good to be honest.
Home opener, so. Did they sign the waiver? You must buy us a new boat.
Well, I thought the one guy died for a second there.
Pardon me.
Well, he got hit pretty hard.
Oh, yes, he did.
The guy yanked him.
He did.
In the back
of
the boat.
Yeah.
So that one was tough. What else? The pony hop, which...
Cheater.
The first time ever we had to stop a contest.
Trust me, we made note of it up here in the broadcast.
Literally told the kid in the concourse, he asked me, what am I doing? I got on the pony and I showed him, you bounce. What does he do? 3, 2, 1.
And pick it up and
runs. Picks it up and runs.
That's called cheating.
That's not the spirit of the race.
Cheating.
They were a lot slower than 40 Erie Racetrack, though, I'll tell you that. Absolutely brutal. So we brought some new ones in. They were amazing. Everything was fun. Speaking of, like, not really on promotions, but our show, like, I think people really liked the new pyrotechnics we did.
It was cool. Cannons. When we were testing them, you know, a couple days before, remember how loud they were?
We were scared.
Like, oh my God, we're going to have a 3M safety day. Earplugs provided by...
They weren't so bad when they're on top of the dugout, though.
No, it looked cool. Like, it's one of those things that's like, whoa, wow.
Then you have Adam out there with his whatever he shoots in the air.
Every time he fires one off, I always look up. Oh, did it go high? Did it go high? And then, oh, a little dud.
Well, as long as no one gets hit by a bottle rocket, I think we're all right.
Or if he just looks in. Oh, hello.
Oh, my gosh. Can you imagine?
Well, I could.
Yeah.
I mean, he's hit himself in the foot already before.
This is true.
And he's hit a house. Maybe true.
No, he didn't.
I'm pretty sure.
Did not happen.
Why anyway, are you dinging?
My wife's texting me.
That's okay.
Yeah. Concession was good.
It must have been, you know, when I went down at the beginning of the game, and I normally go pretty early, the line just to get into the ballpark, and then the concession line was massive.
That was the longest line I think I've ever seen. I think people really wanted the foam fingers.
That's awesome.
We had a lot of people waiting in the parking lot, like, well before game time to get in.
Yeah.
Which doesn't usually happen, because a lot, like, most of our fans just show up, like, right at game time.
Hey, maybe so our the potty's telling. We always say come a little early.
Yeah, it was really nice to see people come early. Especially once we, I think, like, down the line, once we get our new shipping container bar, like, people want to come early to hang out there.
Yeah.
Because we're going to do beer specials in there before the game, so you can come and get...
It's, like I said, I mentioned in an earlier podcast, I walked to every section. And the atmosphere with the music bumping, you know, people were having beers. It was great.
Well,
it was
trying to make it a party.
It's a home opener, people, and you know what? You guys in the city of Welland and the Niagara region produced, and it was amazing.
Well, I will say, got a lot of good reviews about the seats.
Good.
So that was good. They were a little dirty, so apologies.
Is that why we're power washing right now? Can you hear that?
I'm pretty sure that's Rocco literally washing the seats that just got rained on.
Speaking of Rocco, can we talk about first the pitch? Ceremonial first pitch and just the roar of the crowd?
Well, it wasn't even that, so I don't know if people noticed, but he went out there three separate times. He actually went out there before the intros of the players and just stood on the mound.
Yeah.
And we had to bring him back in. We had to rein him back in. He's but, yeah, the crowd erupted for him.
He could come out mid-game, stand in the opposite batter box of the batter,
yep,
and no one would say a thing.
We should probably ask a visiting team once if he can, like, take a pinch hit.
Stop.
Why not?
Even if we're down, who cares?
Well,
down, up, doesn't matter. Planned.
Yeah. We want, like,
top of the ninth inning.
One day signing Rocco at the plate.
Rocco's coming in to pitch one.
Can you imagine he just absolutely destroys a baseball over a house? We have to sign him. Yeah. Long term.
Well, he's already signed, but he is. If he hits a home run,
true.
Everyone is allowed on the field to come celebrate. Yeah. Game is over. Yeah. Rocco hits the home run. The game is over.
Besides that, everything else was.
It seemed pretty top notch.
Like it was top notch.
You know what? There's obviously I talked to you about flaws. Flaws happen. No one noticed them. Good.
Well, that's the thing. Like no one really noticed. Like there was definitely flaws. I mean, we had a brand new video board operator. He's still learning it.
Yeah.
Our concession staff is like 50% brand new people. Yep. They did fantastic. So if you're watching this, for the next few games until they kind of get up to speed, please be nice to our concession staff.
Yep.
They're trying their hardest. They're all pretty much all students. So be kind. I understand the lines are long. We're working on that. We are getting a new concession stand.
Yep.
It just won't be here till like June, July. So please bear with us in the meantime. We're working our hardest to fix that issue. But yeah, be nice to the concession
just
staff.
Just buy the hot dog and the beer at the same time.
You want to throw them a tip? Hey, no one's going to be mad about it.
No, they would appreciate it. We thank you, though, for buying all the beers and the hot dogs because it was a good day.
It was a great day. Today, this sucks.
Yeah, I mean, you're in your gear, rain out gear. But today is, you know, it's something new. We haven't done a rain out podcast. No, so that's exciting.
Oh. We got a special guest.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
Making an appearance.
Where is everybody?
Well, it's rained out.
Yeah, I don't see you see my outfit. Coach is in the house.
Yeah, he's here practicing.
Oh, boy. Yeah, that was coming. You know who hates that whistle?
Who?
Tom Pallone.
Oh, Harry Carey.
Harry Carey hates that whistle. He probably want to take it and put it somewhere, if you know what I mean. Shove it somewhere.
Coach likes Harry Carey, though.
You know that coach was selling coach's nuts?
Pardon me?
On Thursday
I
did not
know this. Say one more
time. Yes, he was going through the crowd selling peanuts, but he was they're calling them coach's nuts.
Bay nuts.
Salty coach's nuts.
Salty coach's nuts. Got any takers?
I don't know where that is on the line of not being good.
I mean,
it's not. It's no different than our interns wanting to wear Speedos to do the grounds crew.
True.
So I don't know where that plays into.
Just shows the excitement and the passion of the interns.
They're actually
excited. Understand it. They get it. This is what we're all about.
Well, it's no different than our new pig. I mean, Kieran is going to be in the new pig because he loves it so much.
Did we just give away who the pig is?
It doesn't. You can see his face.
Yeah, that's true. You can.
So, we can look at some of these names, and I'll look it up right now. There's some freaking funny.
What are the best ones here? Here we go. This is live. We're pulling up Facebook as we speak.
There's 45 suggestions thus far.
Okay.
Hamlet.
Okay.
Sir Hamhock.
Who?
Sir Hamhock.
Sir Hamhock.
Swelland.
I like that one. That's a killer.
Pork and beans.
Okay.
Grand Ham.
That's cool.
Crispy Bacon.
Crispy Bacon.
Sir Based a Lot.
Oh, I see where they did there.
Mm-hmm. Sty Cobb. Super Ham.
Anything that gets me to laugh, I like.
I know.
Super Ham.
Pork Steak John.
That could be three names in one. Pork Crusher, Steak John.
Crusher the Sty Guy.
The Sty Guy. You want to be Sty Guy?
Pork Chop.
Pork Chop, too original.
Bacon, Sir Dr. Evil Pork Chop. Mr. Bacon Bats.
I like that one.
There you go.
I like two there a lot.
And someone just asked, why a pig? Why not as a fish? Well, we've already got Jacques.
Yeah. So now we're going from one end of the spectrum.
So really everything we do here doesn't make really any sense.
You see what he's wearing?
I wear a pizza suit into the crowd and a hot dog suit to throw pizza.
Hold on. Welland does have 38 pizza joints. Yeah. So maybe that's like, you know, you're paying homage to Welland. Welland has a lot of pizza joints.
There's a lot. Yeah. My favorite is Tailgates. The best pizza in Welland.
Good za.
That's a... how you doing, Ryan Nava, the owner over there?
Hey, was that a shout out?
That was a shout out.
Yeah.
To Navs. Mm-hmm. Yes. Where were we on this?
You were talking about, well, one, today was supposed to be a game day, but it's now rained out. Then we got...
These suck.
What?
The rainouts suck.
Oh, I thought you said we suck.
No.
I go, yeah, we lost, but whoa.
Like, these suck because I have to reschedule. I got to tell everybody. We get all these phone calls.
You know how many phones, you know how many times the phone rang and... just the same question. It's like a
telephone. Oh, it's a valid question.
And it is a great question.
My favorite one was when someone called and said, hey, I saw online that the game was canceled. Is that true? And I said, was it on our Twitter? And they said, yes. I said, well, then I safely assume yes.
It's not April Fool's Day. We aren't trying to trick you.
Yeah, I'm not real sure why we say game's canceled if it wasn't, but whatever.
We wouldn't trick you. We always want you here. We hope fans, if you want to still come by, we're here for a little bit.
Yeah, you can come hang out in the potty. Watch. Yeah.
This is live right now. I mean, you're not seeing it live, but...
No. No.
You never know.
Do you want to look at some fan questions here real
quick? I sure do.
Let's see what we got here. I only got one.
Okay, that's all right.
Any ideas or other ideas for in-game promotions this year? I like the new intro pyrotechnics. Yes, pyrotechnics are unreal. That was really good.
Coach put his hand up. He liked
we
that
got one. A couple new ones we're going to be putting in.
You know what we should talk about, and we never gave them a shout out on the podcast before, but Centennial High School, because they just talked about
the intro. Let's talk about on-field promos first, and then we'll get to that.
Oh, okay, cool.
So on-field promos we're going to do a couple new ones. One is actually called, I won't give away what it is, but
okay.
Coach's Undie Race.
Yep.
That'll be one that we'll bring in and out.
Yep.
We also got the Newark Brewery Beer Stein Race.
Yeah, That one has my eyes popping, and I like that one.
That should be interesting.
I like that one.
Yeah, so that one will be pretty cool. We're going to toss more different stuff, maybe some koozies and some socks and stuff like that. If you have a suggestion on a promo.
Hey, always open. Trust me.
We're open for it.
And, you know, when people say, why are we so wild and crazy? I mean, someone asked, why a pig? Well, maybe a pig could be a promo.
Why not?
So, anything's open.
Like...
You know what I know? Did you do Musical Cherries on...
No.
No, we got rid of that.
Can't well, I didn't get rid of it.
We didn't do it, as I'm saying. Yeah, we didn't do it on Thursday.
We don't want to do the same thing every single night.
That's right.
I mean, there's some staples that people love. Like Kiss the Fish.
That's my... We got a new
Brittany from Port Colborne.
From Poco.
She was the first Kiss the Fish of 2023.
Did she really smooch it? Like, did she?
Yeah, it's funny because she said, how many people have kissed this? It's like, well, that's game one, so you.
You are the first one, so you, you're popping that fish's cherry.
Yes.
Hmm.
Well,
I don't think you can say that. Can I say that?
I don't think you can say that.
Uh-oh.
You just did.
Well, actually, it's now funny. You, the editor, get
it's actually pretty funny. So when Coach goes here on Thursday, the producer asked me about the podcast. He goes, can we take those and put them on Coach Go? And my response was, not safe for work. I'm like, yeah, we don't. I mean, there's some borderline stuff that maybe you don't want to put on Coach Go.
Well, we took it to the extreme there, but that's okay. I mean, that didn't say anything too wrong.
This is a behind-the-scenes podcast. Like, we're not going to sugarcoat anything. We might throw some swear words down. If that, you know, that's why when you put on YouTube and says, is this for kids? The answer is no. This is not for children.
14 plus, I think, or whatever. You need your parent or guardian. I don't know what YouTube does, but you need a parent or guardian.
Like, yeah.
There we go. We got confirmation.
Yeah.
We're way off topic, but that's okay.
So, talk about Centennial.
Yeah,
Our opening promo video. Shout out to Michael Krasny. Teacher at Stadium putting this all together, and it looks great. He had students here doing videography, some stuff, and photos and whatnot. But all the clips look freaking amazing.
They were high school students put that together, and there's
like
the amount of quality put in and time and effort, wild. It is wild. Unreal. Like, it makes us look so professional, and they do a tremendous job. I know when I was there last year and they were doing, you know, the behind the scenes, taking the extra time to make our players look so good. That's the end effect right there on the video board.
100%. They were fantastic. I think everybody loved it. The players watched it. They loved it. The
players probably. Where else are you going to get that in the IBL? Nowhere.
Nowhere. It's not a thing.
No.
Not a thing. So,
all right, guys. Feet? Take it easy.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Me and Jox are going fishing. So.
Watch your foot.
Yeah. Okay. I'm out.
All right. Coach is out.
that was close.
Yeah, so you'll see more stuff in the video where we got other things we're going to be doing, more creative stuff. And yeah, it's going to be exciting here. So next home game, Thursday.
Thursday night.
Thirsty Thursday, that's all it is. Come on down and have $4 Tall Boys, a Pond Water Lager, or Liftbridge Light Lager.
Yep.
To the end of the third. We got VIP tables still open, so check those out. The dock's booked. The today's raid out got...
I was just going to say, we can talk about
that. A lot of people asking if Bark the Park's going to be moved. Yes, it is. It's going to be June 1st now, 7:25. Also a Thirsty Thursday. No big deal. So yeah, Bark the Park presented by Pet Food Outlet, and we've got...
bring your puppies.
We've got 500 doggy bags.
And bring, amazing, bring your dogs. Amazing doggy bags, by the way. They're not like little just, hey, you're going to get a couple
they're
of
bone legit. And treat. There's got to be at least like
60 bucks at least.
Get stuff in there. Yeah. I need to get some like leashes and dog collars and like treats and all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
So
please come down. Yeah. June 1st. That's the dog one.
Yeah. How long have you been on for?
How long is it? That's all right.
It doesn't really matter.
Normally we time
it. It tells me right here.
Sometimes we don't.
No, it doesn't.
Well.
Doesn't really matter.
This is what happens on a rainout. And now the real question is, what do you do now?
Because
your day normally has been planned longer.
We're supposed to have a junior game tonight at 6, so we might try to get the field ready for them.
Yep.
But honestly, it's just kind of shore up stuff for next week. And yeah.
Thursday night, next home game. Be sure to join us.
Are we done?
I think so.
All right, wrap it up. Thanks for joining us.
You want out of that suit, don't you?
I am the director of fun, Ryan.
I'm Spencer.
And this is episode
8. Quattro.